Hello, what do we have here? A friend of mine gave me this Anritzo Spectrum Analyzer type MS610A. It operates from 10 kHz up to 2 GHz to check it. The description was no true measurement of frequency. The level also not okay, a little bit noisy. CRT had problems with focus, astigmatism, etc. So he gave it to me and said, check and see what you can do. And so it's here on my bench. Luckily, I have the manual here. It's from 1985, as I see, and the service manual here with full description of all schematics, layouts, and so on, part list, alignment, procedure, and so on. So it's possible to check it. I will see what happens and what I will find out. First, some informations regarding the concept of this spectrum analyzer. It's a purely analog concept. It dates from the late 70s and early 80s from the last century. Input is filtered. First mixer receives the first LO in the range from 2.5 GHz to 4.5 GHz, and the first IF is 2.5 anything GHz. So the span is 2 GHz. 10 kHz to 2 GHz. This IF 2.5 GHz is converted with a second LO 2.5 GHz to the IF of 21.4 MHz. Both oscillators, first and second LO, are not synchronized, no PLL, no digital circuits, nothing. It's a purely analog circuit. This is a YIG-tuned oscillator, YTO. FM coil, tune coil, and it is tuned by the analog potentiometer on the front. There are two pots, coarse and fine, which control the voltage for the tuned oscillator, or better said, the current in the coils. This is the concept here, and the second LO is a free-running oscillator here. Both have outputs here on the rear side to add any tracking generator or something like this. This model here has no tracking generator. This voltage here from the coarse setting is also fed to the digital part and is converted into a digital value and is indicated as a frequency. The tuning voltage indicates the frequency. If there's an error in the AD conversion, in the reference or anything else, then you have a wrong frequency on the display. That's unfortunately a very bad concept, but we cannot change it. We have to live with it. Okay. The IF 21.4 MHz is here converted to the bandpass filter in the range of 3.5 MHz. These filters can be switched. Logarithmic detector, rectifier, amplifier, video filter, and it goes to the CRT here for indication. Truly analog circuit also here. No digital values are transferred, nothing. It's analog everywhere. You see here the voltage, the tuning voltage coming from the potentiometer for the YIG-tuned oscillator. It's AD converted here and sent to the CPU. It's sent to the CPU here and goes to the front panel. And is indicated on the front panel via this interface here. This means that every analog error of this YIG-tuned oscillator here appears one-to-one as an error. The stated frequency accuracy is plus minus 10 megahertz. Not millihertz, megahertz. Plus minus 10 megahertz. It's cruel. It's not state of the art today. It was rather good 40 years ago, but today it is okay. We can live with it for simple purposes. I will show it later, the applications, but today I wouldn't use it. Also, the steps for the spans are switched analog. They are digitally controlled, but if they are analog switches here. So the whole concept is truly analog in spite of a digital display. This digital display indicates something which is not present. totally analog concept. But it's okay, why not? We can work with it. It's rather good and simple and repairable equipment. The spectrum analyzer has one disadvantage. It has no internal memory, no storage function. So with slow sweep rates, you have a very flickering picture, and the CRT does not store anything, and the memory is not installed. So it's a problem to use it with very, very narrow bandwidth or big spans. But there is a solution. For those days, it was a common solution to use a plotter. It can be connected here to the X, Y, and Z output. And then you can take a big paper, and the plotter draws it onto the paper. Additionally, there's an option here installed, General Purpose Interface Bus. There you can also read out the data with a small computer written in BASIC or so on. It's described in the manual here how to use it. It's a GP interface bus, interface option one. There you can plot also pictures on it. It's not very a very high sophisticated technology, but at least such pictures can be drawn here also on the paper. Okay, that's it, and other functions are described in the manual. It's not the intention here in this video to describe all the options and so on, only the basic functions. Okay, let's start. Frequency adjustment. First step is to adjust the zero beat. Go to zero here, it's a DC response. And it should be on the left side. When you have your zero indication. No, sorry, it should be on the right side, of course. But five turns here on the fine adjust here. One, two, three, four, five. And then it should be, hope you see it, on the third line from the right side. One, two, three, not exactly. We have to readjust it. R29. Let's shift it a little bit, so it's now where it should be. Hope you can see it. Yes, that's okay here. And frequency display should adjust between zero center scale, okay. Then we go to the center scale here with zero response. And the frequency here should jump between zero and one, that's okay. 0 MHz, 1 MHz. This analyzer only has a resolution of 1 MHz. As I told you, it's a rather old principle, so it's not better than 1 MHz. It's okay. Not state of the art today, but we can live with it. Then we have to go to the 2 GHz, to the other hand of the spectrum analyzer. And then of course we need a signal of 2 GHz input. We use it here. And as you see, we have here 1999. Frequency is shown here. Hope you can see it. This should be in the center. No, sorry, second line from the left side here. Also not okay here. Z5 R24. R24 is here. Second line here, okay. Then we have to adjust the 1 GHz indication. We go to 1 GHz here on the scale.
Indirect 1 GHz hier. Ups, ein bisschen zu faust hier. It's exactly 1000. And it fits. It should be in the center here. And should indicate exactly 1000. I think it's okay. And we should go to 1.1 GHz. Sorry, it is here. The 1.1, also go here. Oops, a little bit too fast here. It's exactly in the center. Then let's go to the 2 GHz. Set the 2 GHz again into the center. It was under check at 1.1, that's okay. Then I go to 2 GHz here. Exactly 2 GHz here, and the display also shows 2 GHz, 2001, okay. It cannot be done better here, it's a simple analog system here, and it's, I think it's a limit what can be reached here with this technology. Then we have to adjust the full span marker, there's also an option. Frequency span, full span. Okay, that's obviously not okay here. You see here the frequency 2 GHz exactly on the right side here, and this marker here should be exactly here. The adjustment is a little bit difficult here. Because the pot lays a little bit down here. I need an additional lamp here. And we can adjust it here. And now you see the marker here is in line. So it's when I move the marker into full span mode here, that's 2 GHz here. Okay, this was the frequency adjustment. It's a little bit difficult and touchy. I cleaned all the pots before I did it, because the pots were a little bit sensitive and touchy, so I had to clean them. And now it's, I think it's okay. I will do some checks again whether 0 GHz and 2 GHz and 1 GHz and so is okay on the display. And then I will leave it as it is. It makes no sense to invest much more time here into this concept. Another topic is the gain adjustment of the different selection stages here. Depending upon the resolution bandwidth, we have different gains here. The Kreisel filters have different losses or different gains. Depending upon the setting, the resolution bandwidth, so it is necessary to control it. I have here a 50 megahertz never touch a running system. Here it is. We have here the 50 megahertz, and we can toggle between the different resolution bandwidths and see what happens. That's a reference. is a 30 kilohertz setting. So I first choose the 30 kilohertz setting. It's second line from the top here. I use a 50 megahertz internal reference generator, minus 10, minus 20, minus 30 dBm. And all other stages of the crystal filters, you can see them here. Here are the crystals and the filter stages. These filters have to be adjusted with these pots to the same gain for all stages here. We start with 300 kilohertz. It's okay. I could move the span a little bit, but it's okay. So we can increase it a little bit. 10 kilohertz is R51. R51 is third from the top, the bottom here, or third from the top, it's the same. You see, we can adjust it here. Now we are also exactly on the same vertical line here. Now the adjustment of the filters is okay. The filter shape itself, it's okay. I've checked it for all frequencies, for all bandwidths and so on. So it's not necessary to retune the filter, the inductors or the capacities, the trim capacitor here on the filter bank. It's okay. And I will not touch it. Never touch a running system if this is okay here. One of the next steps is alignment of the logarithmic amplifier. That's a little bit difficult because we need to adjust a lot of pots to have a clear logarithmic scale here on the screen and not anything else. First is to adjust the reference voltage of the logarithmic amplifier. There is a adjustment inside a pot and a measuring point. It's on R103, exactly 4.0 volts. I go to it, to this point here. Oops, 392 is it, and I have to adjust it exactly at 4000. Oops, not so good here. 399 4000. Okay, that's good enough. That's a reference voltage for the logarithmic amplifier, 400 volts DC. The next step is the adjustment of the logarithmic amplifier. First, we have to adjust the 10 dB steps. I've connected the voltmeter here to the test point. First, it should be centered to the frequency of the log amplifier. It's around about 29.4 megahertz plus minus some kilohertz. So I have to adjust first the signal generator here to the maximum voltage. I've adjusted here in parallel. This line here is an analog valve tube voltmeter. This VT voltmeter is easier to adjust for the maximum. So I see the maximum is coming up here now. Okay, that's it. 4.199, and I have to adjust this value here with the resistor here to exactly 400 volt. Oops. Sensitive here. Touchy touchy. Okay, that's good enough. This is a reference point for the 10 dB steps. Now the same procedure for the 2 dB steps per division. So first I have to go here to the 2 dB steps. Now this LED here is lit. You see, it is a 2 dB lit LED now. Adjustment is then for what is 400, okay. 4.00 volts with R101. R101 is this here. So I also will adjust it here to exactly, oops, wrong direction. Also very touchy here, 4.00 anything, that's also okay. Now we have adjusted the 2 dB steps. The next step is alignment of the linear scale. this back analyzer also has a linear scale. You can see it here. I've chosen it linear. There's another alignment point here. It's R74. It also has to be adjusted for exactly 400 volts. Okay, forget it. 403, oh goodness. 400, okay. Now all three case are aligned also properly. And a simple check whether the alignment was correct. The position of the measurement line here should not change when switching between 10 dB, 2 dB and linear. All three should be at the same level for the specified input of minus 17 dBm at the log amplifier. Minus 17 dBm at this frequency, 21.400, it's a maximum here, it's locked here, output here, and is fed into this logarithmic amplifier. So it is clear that the reference level is okay for all three modes here, 10 dB, 2 dB and linear. So the line does not jump. You see it? Yes, okay, you can see it. Yes, that's one of the steps. Let's go to the next step. The next step is to adjust the linearity of the 10 dB per steps indication measurement. So we have 10 dB, 20, 30, 40 and so on. And the calibration has to be done at the minus 40 dBm level. That means exactly in the center. I see I have not made the adjustment correct of the gain adjust here. I go a little bit down now. So I'm exactly on the top line here, as stated in the manual. And then I reduce the input power by exactly 40 dBm. I switch down here. 10, 20, 30, 40. It's not exactly, let me check it again. Okay, we are on the top line here. Not exactly, okay, now we're on the top line here. 10, 20, 30, 40 less. It should be exactly in the center. It is not. The voltage here should be exactly 2.000 volts. It's a little bit too high. I have to use R97, and R97 is this one here, so I go to it, oops, wrong direction, oops, TNDB steps. Okay, a little bit too much here. I think now it fits here. Should be exactly 2 volts. Yes. And 40 dBm less are exactly on the center line here. 1.99, okay, forget it. It's 2 volts, so this is linear. That was for the 10 dB per division. And now I have to go to the linearity of 2 dB. The adjustment of the 2 dB steps, 2 dB per division steps, has to be made, of course, in the 2 dB per division position. I've added here a simple attenuator here. It has 1 dB steps, so it's a little bit easier for me to reduce the gain by 2 dB steps than to do it on the analog output of the signal generator here. It's not so easy. It's a little bit touchy here, so it's easier to do it here. Again, we adjusted it on the top level here, and then let's check it. Okay, we are also 10 dB, 2 dB, linear, still okay here. Then we go to 2 dB, and there is a level of the by 2 dB steps, 399. And which each 2 dB more attenuation here should vary by 0.4 volt. 346. Here we have 399. And this step here I have to adjust with R98. I have a list here, okay. R98 here is this one. Oops. A little bit touchy here. Exactly 2 volt. Volt, and here it's on the center line here. A little bit too much up here, okay. Yes, it's okay. 3.9, okay, that's okay. Now we have finished the alignment of the logarithmic detector. We will make an overall adjustment and check after other steps also have been done, but in the moment we are ready with this alignment here of the logarithmic detector. The next step is to adjust the vertical display exactly to the reference level at the log amplifier input. Again, we have connected here to the input of the log amplifier the signal generator with a specified level of -17 dBm. It's exactly -20. Plus 3 is -17 dBm. We are nearby the top center, top line here. When I reduce it by 40 dB, as we had it before, 10, 20, 30, 40, we're arriving here at exactly the center of the. Let's make it a little bit better here. Okay, now you can see it. Sorry. It's exact center line here. 40 dB more, then we are exactly at the top line. 50, 60, okay, 70, now we got to the noise level, 80, that's 80 dB, it's not exactly here in the noise level, but it's cannot be expected more, so it's within the limit of this rig here. It's not a very precise instrument, as I told you before, but it's good enough, so we don't have to adjust the vertical amplifier here, we have nothing to do. And we can close it. Well, the last point is to check or adjust the span width that when we have here, for example, 2 MHz, you can see it, yes, when we have here 2 MHz, that we also have 2 MHz span totally. We set here start frequency 0, that's a 0 response. You see it's 0 response. And this here is a 2 MHz signal coming from my signal generator here. And you see it's exactly 2 MHz bandwidth. A little bit more power, but it's difficult to, you can't see the graticle. There's no illumination of the graticle, unfortunately. But we can shift it a little bit, okay. Then it's here and here. That's 2 MHz bandwidth. No further alignment is necessary. We can simply accepted. Same procedure for 20 megahertz span. We have to select 20 megahertz. Now we have, okay, that's 20 megahertz. Span 20. We are going, oops. So we have here on the left and on the right side, that's a 20 megahertz signal, a zero response. You can see it on the left side. Shift a little bit, so it should be better. The 20 megahertz signal on the right side. It's okay, no problem. Same procedure, we have to do it with one gigahertz span, yes, 1 gigahertz. So we use here 1 gigahertz span. So I inject 1 gigahertz, we go down here. 1996, 998, 999. Okay. The generator produces 1 gigahertz. You see, same principle. Span width 1 gigahertz. Left side is a zero response. Right side is a generator with 1 gigahertz. Same procedure we have to do with a 2 gigahertz span. That means full span. You can see here zero response, 1 gigahertz, and it's a harmonic at 2 gigahertz, but I will tune it to 2 gigahertz. It's easier for us to see. 198, 199, exactly 2 gigahertz. You see again on the right side here. And at full span, there's a dot which can be moved here over the scale. If it's a little bit too noisy, we can add a video filter here, but I think we made a mistake now. Yes, it's too much, 100 hertz. Ah, that's it, okay. Off, 10 kilohertz, okay. It is highlighted, it indicates 2 gigahertz here, but it is okay, as I said, not the best solution here. And then we go down to zero response, to the zero, okay, that's zero here. It fits for this purpose. Well, that have been the last steps here. Frequency display is also made, so we can say this unit is tuned. And I will do the FAT, final acceptance test. This is a separate part of video I will make to show that everything operates, and then this unit can go back to the owner. One of the most important measurements is a measurement of the second and third harmonic distortion. According to the manual, it has to be measured at an input level of minus 30 dBm and input attenuated 0 dB. So this line here, top line here, is minus 30 dBm at any frequency. We have a signal with 100 MHz, a signal with 100 and MHz and 100 kHz. Both signals are added with this hybrid combiner. It's a homemade hybrid combiner. It decouples both inputs with 20 or 30 dB plus attenuation here of these output attenuators, so the signal generators don't see each other. The added signal is fed to the spectrum analyzer. We can see here the input signals centered exactly about 100 megahertz in the center. We have 50 kilohertz or total span of 500 kilohertz. So we have 50 kilohertz per division, that's 100 kilohertz spacing. And here should be the distortion signals, but we don't see any. And this is more than 70 dB, because this is 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 60, 40, 50, 60, 70. The bottom line is 80. So we are below 70 dB, or better than 70 dB TRD level. That there is a problem. If we override it, it can be shown easily. It is increase both levels, input levels, by 10 dB, and you see here the growing TRD signals further increase, second, third harmonic, and so on. So it is overdriven, but as long as we are within the range as specified, we have no problems here. We are better than 70 dB. Okay, let's start with the final acceptance test. I've connected again a signal of exactly 2 GHz, 2.000 and something. We have here a frequency error of, let me say, 3 MHz. It's within the limit of plus minus 10 MHz. I can open it, retune it again, close it, it's again wrong. It makes no sense because it depends upon the heating. The unit gets rather warm here on the top after 1 hour operation. It's now more than 1 hour under operation. And then we go down to 1 GHz. And we tune the generator also to 1 GHz. And 39.96431. 9.99. So we have exactly 1 GHz, and when I tune it here, okay, it's 9.98. I can live with it. Let's go to for example 1.5. why not, we have enough time here. 1.5, I tune it to 1.5. 1.5000. Oops. It's 1.5 here. I tune the center frequency. 1.502. 2 MHz error. Let's go down to, let me say, 500 MHz. What the unit tells us here. Oops. Exactly 500. And tune it in. 499.500. Okay, it's within the limit. The lowest possible frequency here with this generator is approximately 20. That's a zero response here. It's zero. Okay, we have tuned a little bit more. It makes 1 MHz. I'm just here on the tipping point here. Try 20 MHz here. Okay, I should reduce, you see the harmonics here. I should use the frequency span. 20 MHz. Resolution bandwidth could be a little bit less. Let's go to 100 kHz, and I reduce the amplitude also a little bit. Okay. Maybe 21. It's within the limit here. Just one. It's 20 MHz. Okay. Frequency seems to be okay. Then let's check the vertical linearity. For this purpose, I will go to the 50 MHz and use an external signal generator here. I can use this cable here, it's okay. Go to 50 MHz. Material und dann adjusted it to 0 dBm. Sorry, a little bit. Now it's 0 here. Not exactly here. Sorry. I have to adjust the gain here to come up to exactly 0 dBm. Reference level 20 MHz. Bandwidth, it's a signal coming in with 50 MHz. To have a better picture, I will use the 10 kHz. It's tuned in 50 MHz. I can take it a little bit away here. No, it's not good. Not so good. Then I reduce the input level by exactly tuned here. Due to the analog concept, it's always necessary to have a gain adjust. When you know the input level, you can tune it to the exact level which is given in the input. Now reduce it to minus 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Now it's in the noise level. Can reduce the noise level a little bit more when I go to 1 kHz. I have to reduce the frequency span, of course, because at the frequency of one with a resolution of 1 kHz, you shouldn't have a big span, otherwise you have a problem, and the sweep time could be a little bit increased to make the picture a little bit more smooth. And the video filter, I think, would help here. Okay, yes, but not so much. It also decreases the amplitude. It's not so good. Video filter is always dangerous. But now I can try it again. Minus 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. 70, 60, 50, 40, 30, 20, 10, 0. Okay. 10 dB range is okay. No problem. Should be okay for all other frequencies also. We can check it in the gigahertz range with the gigahertz generator I have here. We will do it. We will do it now, but first I want to check the 2 dB steps. I reduce it by 10 dB, then it should be one line below center line. That's it. Nearly perfect. Okay. 2 dB range is also okay. Linear is not easy to check. It's only linear, it's voltage. That was it on 50 MHz. Then I can go to frequency 2 GHz or something like this. Just have to move a little bit. Gigahertz signal. It 2000, waren also a bit more than 2000 here. Okay. 2004 as we had before. The output level of the signal generator here is not calibrated because I have a power divider here for the frequency counter. So I have to manually select the reference level. I just only want to check the steps. And then I reduce the output voltage by output power by 10 dB, 20, 30, 40, 50. That's okay here. I could reduce the noise level a little bit. And then the frequency span also. And you see the frequency problem of the stability, it's not so good, but we can, oops, ah, yes, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, and so on. So this is also okay in the gigahertz range. I can live with it. I have to live with it. Just a small demonstration what we can measure with this instrument here. I've prepared a 500 MHz signal, amplitude modulation. I'm using first the linear scale. Linear scale means we see a voltage, not power, no dB, nothing, it's voltage. If we have a modulation degree of 50%, then each sideband has 25% amplitude. I increase the AM to 50%, and you say it's about a quarter, 2 divisions, 8 divisions. So this is a quarter of the carrier, both sidebands, and you see here also some very, very small harmonics. It's, I think it's a question of the generator. When I further increase the modulation degree, 75 degree, 80 degrees, so you see the amplitude goes a little bit down and the sidebands are increasing. Let's again look at this 25% modulation degree AM. We switch to 10 dB. That means the first sidebands are approximately 10 dB below the level. I will just draw it. Okay. A quarter of voltage means approximately 16th of the power. That means 11, 12 dB under the carrier. That is nearly the difference between carrier and both sidebands. This is a little bit more than 10 dB here. It can be 12 dB. Can we measure it on the 2 dB line here? Yes. If it 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and a little bit. Okay, it's a little bit more than 10 dB. Below the carrier. I don't know whether the 50% modulation degree is absolutely perfect of this generator. I'm not so sure. Anyhow, we see what we want. Amplitude modulation. Just for information, the modulation frequency is, let me say, 100 kHz. I've made it to have a little bit bigger picture and to see what happens. Next topic is frequency modulation. Again, carrier 500 MHz. I've chosen 100 kHz modulation frequency, and deviation up to maximum is 640 kHz deviation. When I switch FM on, you see first two sidebands similar to AM, but with increasing deviation, you see that the carrier in the center disappears. And with more deviation, the carrier comes again, but other sidebands are disappearing. So we have always sidebands coming up, sidebands disappearing, and the frequencies are always coming up and going down when the deviation increases. The reason is very simple. At FM, the amplitude is constant. If some frequencies come additionally on it, so it's necessary to reduce other frequencies to have a constant amplitude. It's a Bessel function. If you have seen ever such Bessel diagrams, you can see which harmonic appears and disappears. That's frequency modulation here. That's the reason why you never can say that a frequency has a specified bandwidth. Theoretically, the bandwidth is infinite because you always find some harmonics, but from a certain frequency on, the harmonics disappear in the noise level. So it is not existing, not measurable, but it's still theoretically existing. Bandwidth is unlimited in FM. So it's always difficult to say we have only 10 or 20 kHz bandwidth for amateur radio purposes and so on. Well, that was it. This unit is checked, aligned, corrected. I also have cleaned some contacts inside and some pots. We had some problems with it. Now it's okay, and I can give it back to my friend, and we'll see what he will do with it. The last check I will do is the test of the dynamic range, especially for the average noise level. According to the manual, it is specified with 115 minus 115 dBm or less at a resolution bandwidth of 1 kHz and video filter 100 Hz. Frequency 1 MHz or more. Okay, we have 70, we can choose anything. Important thing is, stop here, important thing is to reduce the resolution bandwidth to 1 kHz. It's the smallest one this unit has. That's a zero response, not so important. We can reduce the frequency span, let me say, to 10 MHz. Let's go to 100 kHz. And the reference level has to be made as low as possible. We can go down here. It's minus 50 dBm. Minus 50 dBm is the top line here. And we need a video filter with 100 Hz. Okay, you see the difference. Noise. 10 kHz video filter, no big difference between, because the time, the sweep time is very high. It is, let me say, 0.2 seconds. But at 100 Hz, you see it. And now we can count. Let's start here. Minus 50 dBm. The top line here, minus 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, minus 110, minus 120 is the middle mean value here of this noise level, minus 120 dBm. It is stated here with minus 150 dBm or less. Okay, I think the noise level here is also acceptable and we can live with it. Okay. That's all important tests I have done. The rest is also okay. Scale linearity, output of the 50 MHz generator, I have tested it. Span width is okay, and so on. That means this unit is ready now. It can go back to the owner, to my friend, and we will see what happens.